So what is going on, guys? Welcome back to yet another episode on the camera flying series. And in today's episode, we're gonna get right into it, and I'm just gonna teach you guys real quick how to assemble a camera helmet. So it's gonna be an overview of what you're gonna need, some of the safety features of the helmet, as well as how to properly assemble it. So I'm not gonna go into depth on how to do this since it's pretty self-explanatory, but of course if you guys have any questions on any specific part, you can always ask in the comments. So let's start with the components of our helmet build. We're going to have the helmet itself. My choice of helmet in this case is the Tonfly 2x. It's a great camera helmet. It has chin cup, has a cutaway system, and it has a base plate on the top. It has a TF mount, actually, so for me that's more than enough. Up next, what we're going to need is our cameras. So in terms of cameras, we're going to have a mirrorless camera, which is going to be our stills camera, and a video camera, which is going to be a GoPro. So our Canon M6 Mark II is our stills camera, and our GoPro 6 Black Edition, Hero 6 Black Edition, is going to be our video camera. Now, usually people sometimes use camcorders and use a GoPro as a backup. I use the GoPro because I love the video from the GoPros. Maybe when I do need to do a specific video work, I do put a 15-45 image stabilized lens on the Canon and use the Canon as the video camera, but in this case it's not going to be needed because we're only going to do stills and video on the side. So what we're going to need, of course, is a way to assemble the GoPro. So we have here our GoPro case, the base plate that comes with the helmet. Of course you have to attach it. Mine's already attached. It's pretty simple, and of course this doesn't come with the attachment. It's a sheer clamp. It's also pretty useful, and you'll see why. We're gonna need the actual TF mount base plate and the GoPro, or the Canon DSLR or mirrorless camera base plate, which is right here. Tonfly also sells that. And all these little elastic pieces are all protections, these fabric pieces and elastic pieces. And of course, we're gonna need our sights. This video is not gonna include how to adjust your sight, but I will make a video about that. We're also going to need a remote shutter for the camera, for the mirrorless Canon. This is a 2.5mm jack, and we have a blow switch. That's our system, so that's the system I use. So let's actually start assembling the helmet itself. Now, first of all, let's start with the simplest piece, which is the GoPro. So what I'm going to do is grab our GoPro case over here, and we don't need to insert the GoPro, but I will insert the GoPro now. Just make sure it has a battery and a card inside. It's always useful, but you can open it later the way the system is assembled. And if you were to use the original bolt that came with this helmet, you would just have to screw it on with like a screwdriver or something. I modified mine by drilling, getting a drill bit that fits on the first two holes, and the third hole is actually tape threaded. So I just drilled all the way through. That way I can just do this. I can stick my GoPro right in here, there you go, put on my clamp, and I'm good to go. This way, if I need to adjust anything on the fly while I'm on the plane or something, I can do it easily without having to undo my bolt. And if I did have the bolt loose enough so that I could change stuff on the air, it probably would undo itself, or even just a little hit and it would go loose. So I think this is the best way to do it. Just don't leave the clamp too loose. There you go, sounds about right. So now we have our GoPro on. If you're wondering about this base plate over here, this used to be when I used to run two GoPros, one for video and one for photos. Well, you all already use it, so yeah. Now we're gonna attach our DSLR, or our mirrorless camera, in this case the Canon M6 Mark II, with a Viltrox speed booster and a Canon 20mm f2.8 USM lens. It's a great setup, I recommend it. So what we're doing here is we're just putting our quarter of an inch, 1 3/4 of an inch, whatever this bolt's called, this American bolt on the bottom here, that just holds this is all that holds the camera in. So you don't need to over tighten it, because if you break the camera, you know, you're breaking your camera. But just get it tight enough so that you don't lose your camera in free fall. And of course this little strap helps protect the camera and the switches of the autofocus, and if you have image stabilization, the IS switch as well. And now what we want to do is we just want to slide the base plate on until it clicks. And I always give a little tap so that it clicks all the way. Here's the little pull switch, pull tap for you to undo it. And now we're gonna start connecting our cameras. So if you turn on your camera, it should turn on. My camera does not have a card on it, but you know, it should turn on. And we're gonna connect our remote shutter release, done. And this remote shutter release kind of acting as a protector so that no lines from the canopy get stuck in here. It's not really that big of a deal. They really don't come in here, but because it's just a small gap. And now before we actually do anything, I'm just gonna test out if this is actually shooting. So, wonderful. I love this camera, but I use it on a low speed continuous drive. Now that the camera is actually working, we can plug it off. These cameras auto go to sleep automatically, so you don't need to always plug them on and off. Now what we're gonna do is we're actually gonna start assembling our safety features, you know. So first of all, there's a big gap in front of the lens, as you can see here, where lines can get stuck. So we're gonna protect it using a little piece of elastic that I did on the rigging shop. I'm gonna show you guys how to do this on a time lapse real quick. So as you can see, I'm just doing a loop with a piece of, I think it's an inch thick elastic, and that goes all the way around the camera and the GoPro. So the lens and the GoPro, and then it has a Velcro on the ends. You don't need a Velcro, but you can add it if you want to. So after you have this thing done, it's pretty easy. You can ask your rigger to do it. You can probably hand make it too if you use a little bit of tape. You're just gonna put it on right on the lens, as you can see here, and on the GoPro. There you go. See? Now this might slip off, so what I do is right on the bottom here, I get it looped under the clamp so that it gets stuck on the clamp and it doesn't actually jump off when the wind hits it. I've lost one of these in free fall and one of these on the ground because I'm always distracted. So, you know, just make one or two. If you don't have a swim machine on hand, you can make a couple of them. And this little piece here, I actually have it just to protect this little part here so that no lines get stuck there too. Now, it's not really necessary, but it is useful. I'm sorry, I'm just gonna look at it because I can't see what I'm doing. So I'm just gonna get it stuck now. And there you go. Perfect. So this is what it should look like once you're finished. So let's see if the camera focuses. Come on, you got this. Come on. There you go. So this is what it should look like. See from the sides. See lines are getting under that lens, hopefully. Of course, nothing is foolproof. And now we're gonna do another mod, which is, see this gap over here? We can also get the stuff stuck in this gap. So we're gonna cut the little piece of Velcro with a little bit of glue on the back. This is white Velcro and this is black Velcro. I had it on my 100D and I had to change it for my M6 Mark II. So this is how I did it. You just gotta cut it and don't forget to round those corners so that you don't so that it doesn't start to undo itself. And then you pick up this little piece here, which is super simple to do on any sewing machine that you have. Just two pieces of Velcro, and these are two trim tapes. Or binding tapes, sorry, trim tapes, whatever. You can use any old strap, as long as it's not too stiff, it will work. And then what you do is, one of the parts goes right in here, as you can see, and the other part goes on the camera itself. Now, you can actually make it a little bit more look good, you know. And as you can see, with this simple solution, no lines are getting under your camera. And you're not losing your camera and you're not losing your life. So it's a win-win, I think. Last thing is the controversial elephant in the room, what they say. Isn't that what they say? Which is this sight. It's a beautiful, let's see if it wants to focus this close. I mean, this lens is supposed to focus quite close, isn't it? Come on, you're not a macro, but you got this. Come on, yeah. It's as close as you can get. So you can't actually see, but you know, it's a concentric sight. So you really gotta go up close to see it, I guess. Just gonna put it right where it belongs. As you can see, this one is removable and it leaves the bracket on so that you don't have to constantly unscrew the nylon bolts, which you will break. And of course you can move it out of the way as all sights to land so that you don't have to look at this thing for a whole jump. Of course, adjusting the sights it's a whole different process, but a good place to start off is having the camera and the GoPro aligned. So if they are both the lenses are flat, and both of the lenses are aligned in this direction. So looking from here and looking from the top, it should be halfway done for you, okay? So we got everything. This should be, in my opinion, a good helmet to go and jump, except for the fact that the Canon doesn't actually have a card. Other than that, this is good to go. So if you guys have any other opinions or things you'd like to share, you can do so in the comment section down below. And I'm gonna leave you guys to it. See you next time.